Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and today I'm excited to introduce to you another one of my favorite crafts, which is sublimation. So a lot of people hear about sublimation in crafting groups because it can be a really good companion for your vinyl crafting business or just a vinyl crafting hobby. But sublimation is actually a completely different monster of its own. Now, if you have ever dabbled using the Cricut infusible ink, then that is basically the same process that we're going to talk about today. Infusible ink is based off the same types of principles, and I only bring it up because infusible ink is often used as an introduction to test out the process of sublimation. So, what exactly is sublimation? What can I use sublimation for? What can I use it on? And what do I need to get started? We are going to answer all that and more and give you a nice little welcome guide into the world of sublimation. Let's get started. So the first thing to know about sublimation is I call it my special craft. And there's a reason for that, I promise, not because I just really like it, but I do. But I call it my special craft because you need a special printer that has special ink, and you use special paper, and you need special substrates. So what that means is, to break it down, you need a sublimation printer that's able to print using sublimation ink. Only sublimation ink can be used with sublimation substrates, which are specifically coated substrates, or they're made of a certain material, okay? So hopefully you're following along. The two most common printer types are going to be a sawgrass printer or an Epson printer. And of course, there's a whole slew of reasons why you would want to choose one or the other. So we won't get into that today, but just know that you have two options to research. And of course, we're gonna have a video on that for you, because I really want you guys to have as much information as possible for making this decision. But to finish your introduction, let me show you some examples first, and then we'll talk about how you can create your own sublimation items. So literally everything that you see on this work table right here is sublimation. All right. This is a book pocket pillow. This is a glitter water bottle. We actually have a video on this one already, okay? You can sublimate on polyester shirts. So of course, this is one of my favorites. This is a sublimation garden flag, okay? Then of course, you can sublimate on special canvases. We have videos for these too. This is one of the easiest things to start out with, in my opinion, okay? Look at this. I did this last Christmas. It's a pillowcase. And this is great for children because it matches up on their pillow to make it look like they're wearing, this one is an elf hat, but they had all kinds of different ones. These are polyester blankets. Okay, this I actually found locally. This was a local find. Information like this hits the Facebook groups and everybody goes nuts, but that'll be important in a minute. And then this awesome pillow here, okay? So I'm using those as a way to show you that you will get projects using sublimation that you cannot get using vinyl. Now, yes, of course, something like this you could do with a printable material from your inkjet, all right? The biggest difference though is that this is forever. I mean, as long as your substrate holds up, the sublimation ink is in there in the fibers. This isn't like vinyl that's going to peel up after a couple washes. This isn't something that, is going to crack and fade over time. It is literally, so this is a doormat, another great local find. We have a video on these too, but I sublimated this last year. Okay. This is not one that I just did recently. This is a doormat that I sublimated last year. Now, obviously this was not a high traffic area, but there's no fading, there's no cracking. Like, it looks just as good today as it did when I sublimated it. So now let's talk about the types of items that you want to use for sublimation. All right, so we talked about the printer. So that's step one, buy a printer. Step two, either make sure it is using sublimation ink or buy sublimation ink, okay? And again, that'll depend on your printer. So those go hand in hand. You also want to use sublimation paper. Now, let's hit the pause button. A lot of people are having fairly good success, or pretty good success, depending on how you look at it, using regular copy paper, okay? Now, that is true if you are going to print and press. The difference is that sublimation paper is specially coated so that the ink pretty much sits right on that top layer. I have been able to use sublimation prints that I printed last year, and they still look good after pressing them today. Now, the reason I go into that is just to prepare you that, of course, you can do some research and you can use regular copy paper, but there is a reason why you would want to invest in the sublimation paper too. So, one more topic for you to research, right? I recommend using the sublimation paper. So, printer, ink, paper, those are all your basics. That's your basic setup. Now, what do you use sublimation on? There's a whole slew of vendors that you can find where you can order sublimation blanks online. Even some of your favorite vinyl vendors, because sublimation is such a booming topic right now, they have started carrying sublimation blanks. So that's a really good place to start. Of course, you can do a basic web search for sublimation blanks, but you know, if you have companies that you already trust, why don't you check out what they have? On top of that, you know, a lot of times you get your printer in and you want to try it now. Let's do it now. I want to do it now. You can actually go to like your local Dollar Tree, your local Walmart, Target, and you can find things locally that you can sublimate on. Now, of course, I always recommend dollar stores because guess what? All your things are going to be a dollar or right around a dollar, right? Things that you can find at a dollar store are going to be like polyester socks, microfiber towels. You know, it's not going to be like the best of the best because they're cheap items. But what you're looking for here are cheap, inexpensive blanks that you can practice on. Just like we don't practice on expensive stuff when we start with vinyl, we don't want to practice on expensive stuff when we start with sublimation. All right. Now, with that being said, also expect that if you are using items that are not meant for sublimation, your results are not going to be as good. So make sure that you thoroughly research whatever your first project is, all right? Don't be afraid to jump in there. You can print small prints and you can press them, okay? But just know that sometimes the quality is reflected in the item that you're using. Practice with the cheap stuff, but be prepared to get really good results once you invest in the more expensive materials. Okay. So for example, sublimation vendor, these were bought in bulk, but these have a special laminate sheet on there. So check that video out before you jump into it. Walmart, this was one of my favorite vinyl vendors. This was bought from an online t-shirt vendor. I just had to make sure that I knew what the polyester count was. You really don't want to sublimate on poly cotton blends, unless you're going to do a bleach or a vintage looking shirt, because it'll fade. So try to make sure that you find shirts that have, for example, this one is 91% polyester. If you could find 100%, that's really great too. But sometimes you do have to settle for a blend. This doormat, these are found at Home Depot. These are found at Walmart. This was found at Walmart. And this, once again, was found at one of my favorite vinyl blanks dealers, okay? So don't feel like you have to go overboard. I'm not gonna lie, when I first started sublimation, I literally drove straight to my nearest sublimation warehouse and I was like, give me all the blanks, you know? So I placed this huge order before I ever even knew what I was really doing, okay? So let's talk about some other things that we can do to prepare you or get you ready for sublimation. First of all, you need to have some sort of graphics program. Now, if you buy a Sawgrass, then it's going to have its own graphics program that you can use. You don't have to, but you can, okay? I personally print all of my sublimation from Silhouette Studio. Now, not everybody loves Silhouette Studio. That's okay. If you already have Adobe Illustrator, affinity designer. You know, there are a ton of different designing softwares that you can use. Some people, they buy the graphics and they print it straight from Microsoft Word or Microsoft Publisher. You're not limited to what you can do, but you have to know how to take these graphics and arrange them, or if you're gonna do any type of modification, and do that in a way so that you're going to be happy with it. For example, I bought this, I didn't do any modifications, I just printed it out and pressed it. But for this one, I personalized it with a name, okay? For this one, I took graphics and I added text. So you do not have to be a graphic design professional. When I talk about using a graphics software, you just need to have a software that you either know or can learn the basics. All right. Then, of course, once you get more experienced, you can learn more into designing and whatnot. You know, of course, I mean, Design Bundles has really great designs already, but I'm just throwing it out there. Now, let's talk about a few other tips. Number one, you want to use blowout paper, not your Teflon sheet. You want to get butcher paper and be prepared to throw it away or recycle it in some fashion after every use. What happens is, let's talk about the process of sublimation. I probably skipped over the most important part, right? So sublimation ink, when heated, will basically, it turns into a gas and it transfers from the sheet into your substrate. Now, we won't get technical, you know, the technicalities of how it happens is above my head anyway, but basically it re-solidifies into the fibers of what we are working with. So what that means is that while this process is occurring, we need the blowout paper to capture any ink that's trying to escape, because you can get sublimation ink residue in your heat press, on your easy press, you know, and we don't want that, because what'll happen is that can transfer onto your next project. So we use the blowout paper to capture all of that ink that's trying to escape. Also, the Teflon sheet is going to trap in moisture, and we don't want that when we're sublimating either, because all that excess moisture can cause problems with our print transfer process. So we talked about how it happens. Basically, you are going to set up your design in your software, print it out on your printer with this special sublimation ink, and then you're going to line it up with your substrate and press it on with your heat press. Now, let's hit the pause button here, because you are going to press, well, not for everything, but for most of your starting projects, your starting point for pressing is going to be 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 60 seconds. Now, if you have, we'll say, more delicate items, for example, sometimes white t-shirts can scorch really easy. You will want to experiment with those. A lot of times your sweet spot is going to be, say, 385 for 50 seconds, you know? So sublimation does have a bit of a learning curve in that not everything is going to press for the same time or the same temperature. If you are buying your blanks from a reputable sublimation dealer, they will be able to tell you. And a lot of times they have it right on their website and they'll say, okay, you're gonna press this for, you know, 365 for 45 seconds. So that's just an example, but you can, for your items that you're finding locally, I suggest keeping a notebook. All right, you can write them all down. That way, a year from now, when it's time to do more Christmas blankets, you already have a starting point. You can pull out that notebook and say, hey, these settings worked great for me last year. All right, now your heat press, it does matter. I'm not saying that if you have a cheap starter heat press that you can't start there. You know, I'm a real big fan of not making these huge investments into brand new crafts that you may or may not like. If you already have a heat press, that is a great starting point. Same thing if you have a Cricut Easy Press 2. All right, anything that will heat up to 400 degrees is a great starting point for at least testing out sublimation. Unfortunately, if you have an original Cricut Easy Press, the temperature does not go up that high. So that may be something that you want to try out. Also, sometimes if you have a local vinyl store or if you have a friend with a heat press, you know, just give them a shout and be like, hey, I don't know if this is something I want to do or not. You want to play with some sublimation? Okay? And you know, your local vinyl stores really are a great resource. So I'm just planting that seed because a lot of us, you can really you know, go in and pick their brain, and I have converted so many people to sublimation that it's borderline ridiculous is what it is, but it's a true thing. So what else do we need to talk about to get ready for sublimation? Let's start from the beginning. I know I'm reiterating some information, but I want to make sure that I cover it. We've bought our printer, we have our ink, we have our paper. We talked about our heat press. We talked about you can purchase designs, potentially personalize them, okay? And I'm gonna be honest with you, that is the majority of what is involved in sublimation. Now, once you really get into sublimation and you decide, hey, I wanna do this as a business, maybe I wanna add this to my existing business, well, then you can start talking about investing in, you know, the fact that you can powder coat your own sublimation blanks, okay? Or maybe I want to experiment with treating cotton t-shirts to accept sublimation. Or, you know, maybe I need to invest in a wider format heat press so that I can press full color sublimation t-shirts. This is really a craft that can grow with you. All right. But do you remember how in the beginning I talked about how this would complement your existing vinyl business or hobby? Okay. Because it really opens up a whole new possibilities that you cannot get with vinyl. All right. So for example, you know, with vinyl for decorating t-shirts, you obviously you press the vinyl on there, but you're restricted to what you can cut with your cutter. So obviously with vinyl, you're not going to get a nice watercolor design. Again, you can print it on a printable transfer, but those do not last as long as regular vinyl, and they certainly don't last as long as sublimation. Now, I say that they complement each other because not only can you add these new types of products, but guess what? You can use sublimation on white glitter heat transfer vinyl and turn it into just really, really awesome designs. There's two benefits to that. Number one, it allows me to sublimate on cotton, which remember I told you, you can only sublimate on polyester. But if you pair it with vinyl, they go hand in hand and open that up for you. And then number two, it allows you to sublimate on dark colors. So whereas sublimation printers do not print white ink, typically speaking, entry-level sublimation printers do not print white ink, pairing it with your existing vinyl business, you can do a print and cut on Caesar Easy Subly. And that is a really good material. Now that still kind of rolls us back to applying vinyl on the shirt, but it's better than a printable because that sublimation ink is bonded with the vinyl. It's not an inkjet transfer where the ink is on top and it's gonna crack and it's gonna fade. All right, the Caesar Easy Subly and Sublimating on Glitter HTV are both really great complementary items that you can add to your already existing business on top of all these awesomeness that you have going on here. So of course, I expect that you're going to have a lot of questions. I really have tried to pack as much information into this as I can. But sublimation is one of those things, it's almost like the tip of the iceberg. What you're gonna do now is you're gonna go out there to Facebook and you're gonna join all these sublimation groups and you're gonna research and you're gonna watch tons of videos. Make sure you check out Design Bundles videos because we have several sublimation videos on here for you to check out. But, you know, research, research, research. Definitely make sure that you check out, you know, it's an investment, but it's an investment in yourself and what you can do. And I just really like it. I really do like sublimation. I always joke that if I had found sublimation first, that I would have never bought a vinyl cutter. And really, that's not true because they do go hand in hand, but it is just a really great, great craft to get into. Of course, all those questions, make sure you put them in the comments below because you guys know I always come back and check in with you. And even if I don't have the answer for you, I will give you the best information I have and either help you find it or point you in the right direction. So, and make sure you subscribe to the channel because just like we already have videos on sublimation, we also have a lot more sublimation and vinyl videos for you right around the corner. So thanks for watching today. I really appreciate it and we'll see you next time.